Now let's talk about the cone clutch, and the first case we'll talk about is the uniform pressure. So we look at cone clutch first of all. So this is how a cone clutch looks like. Okay, so this is the driving shaft which is connected to a prime mover, maybe an engine or maybe whatever the prime mover is, okay, or a turbine. And then this is the driven shaft. So it has a cone like shape. You can see this is a cone. This is a cone, and the half angle of this cone is alpha, and then you have the inner cone which is of the driven shaft. Okay, so the outer cone and the inner cone, they mate each other, and this is how the drive is transmitted. So this shaft has a drive and this cone has a drive, which is the outer cone. When this outer cone mates the inner cone with the help of this friction lining, the drive is transferred from this driving shaft onto this driven shaft. Okay, so this is how the drive is transferred in a cone clutch. So let us say, if you look at this friction lining, this distance is R1 and the distance of this point is R2 from the center line. So R1 and R2 can be, you know, said to be the radii of the friction lining. So if you go ahead, so look at this, R1 and R2 are the inner and the outer radii of frictional conical surface. Okay, so if you go back a bit again, this, so this is how it is, this is the surface, this is the surface. Okay, so this goes for the outer radius and this goes for the inner radius, and this is the surface R1 and then R2. Okay, now this is depicted here as well, R1, R2. Okay, so what we have done is we have taken a small elementary length over here, which is DL. Okay, and the width of this is B, the total width is B. Okay, and if you look at this, this is how it looks like in an enlarged fashion. So if this is DL, this hypotenuse is DL, so this perpendicular length is DR, that's the radial difference, DR, and this angle is alpha. So sine alpha is DR by DL. Okay, so we'll go to that in a moment. So let's define these now. So we have DL, DR, we have alpha, PN. PN is the normal pressure between the contact surfaces. This normal to the inclined surface. Okay, then width of the conical surface B. Mu is the coefficient of friction and alpha is the semicone angle. Okay, now as I told you that if you look at this, dr by dl is sine alpha. So the value of dl in terms of dr is dr cosecant alpha. Okay, so area of the ring would become 2 pi r into dl, where dl is equal to dr cosecant alpha. So this is the area of the elementary ring. So we are talking here about the uniform pressure. In the next video, we will talk about the uniform wear. Okay, now what is the normal load acting on the ring? That would be this. If you go back, this is the normal pressure. So on this DL length, okay, this is the normal pressure. We know the area. So if you multiply the area with this normal pressure, you get the normal load on this ring, which is DWN. The axial load which is acting on the ring is this, dW n sin alpha. How? So your axial load is this, and your normal load to this surface is like this. Okay, and this angle is alpha. All right, so this is WN. So you can see that there is a relation between these two. So you will have this dWn sine alpha. Okay, so we know the value of dWn, which is 2 pi pn r dr. Okay, it will come from dA. dA is this 2 pi r dr cosecant alpha, and pn is already there. So your axial load becomes this. Okay, so total load would be an integral. So we'll keep this outside the integral sign because this is a constant value, and you will get r dr from r1 to r2, and this will be the final value. So W is equal to pi pn, which is the normal pressure on the contact surfaces, into the difference of squares of the radii. Okay, and the normal pressure would be this. Make a note of this. Okay. Now, once we have that value of W and Pn, we'll talk about the frictional force on the ring, which is dF, which is mu into dWn. That is the normal load. Now, the frictional torque would be dF into the radius. So you keep on putting the values of Pn. So this is dF. So dF has already one r. So r into r gives you r square, and then you integrate. Very similar to what we did in the single plate clutch, and the integration would give you this part. Okay, so if you combine 2 by 3, okay, and this part, that gives you the mean radius. So mean radius for a cone clutch considering uniform pressure is 2 by 3 r2 cube minus r1 cube by r2 square minus r1 square. So this is the same as the single plate clutch. Okay, and the only difference is that you have a cosecant alpha term extra in cone clutch if you assume uniform pressure. So make a note of these mathematical formulas for the calculation of numericals. After uniform pressure of cone clutch, we'll move on to the next topic and talk about a cone clutch under uniform wear.